be as honest as you can with creating, with recreating the sound that you're recording. I think if you mess about with things too much and try and make it something that's in your head rather than what is actually happening, I think that's the only way to do it. Be as true to what is actually going on in the room as is possible. My name is Matthew Cocker, and I'm an archive engineer here at Abbey Road. Abbey Road is—it's just impossible to replicate anywhere else. You can't get the same experience from the people surrounded by the absolute professional, lovely, delightful, charming fellow engineers, and everybody who works here. You know, it's a very familial thing. But you have some backup, of course, from a technological point of view. You just have the state-of-the-art equipment, the technical engineers who can support all your needs. Just you can't replicate that at home. Bowers and Wilkins, I've been working with my entire career. They give such clarity, and that's what I've always needed, because you need to be able to hear clear detail without being harsh, you know. So it's a very true reproduction of the sound, and that allows me to do my job very well, because I know I'm going to get a detailed reproduction that's clean. Little details captured during the recording process, I think, add a huge amount to the whole experience of listening to it. The Beatles, for example, who recorded so much at Abbey Road, virtually everything. I know the fans absolutely love it when they get a new released package, as happened with the Sgt. Pepper in 2017 and the White Album last year. They get discs of bone-up material which has different takes on, but also little bits of talk that you might hear. And there was a wonderful discovery they made for the White Album last year. We found at the end of a tape that no one had ever heard before, of just John Lennon playing and strumming Julia, the song that he wrote, but it was in a version that no one had ever heard before. And it's just so immediate. It is as though he is sitting opposite you and playing at you. And then, of course, he stopped and chats to George Martin, the producer. So you've even got that little bit on the end, which makes it live. You know, it's absolutely extraordinary. Mix sounds finished to me when it hasn't muddied, and you haven't gone too far down the road of trying to make things, in inverted commas, better. Because it's very easy to keep working on something, because you think it can always just be tweaked a little bit more, or a little bit brighter, or have a little bit more bass, whatever it might be. But the danger is, if you keep doing that, your ears start to lie to you and tell you all sorts of things that are not actually right, and you go further and further away from the honesty, as I say, of the sound that you're looking to have. So it's knowing when to say stop, I think, and backing away and let it go, you know.